Welcome, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us today. My name is Erin Pollard, and I'm the Project Officer for ERIC at the Institute of Education Sciences in the U.S. Department of Education. I oversee ERIC from the government's perspective. Today is National Thesaurus Day, so it is a perfect day to release information on the latest update to the ERIC Thesaurus and Identifiers. Today, I'm joined by Lydia Helwerk-Dawson, the Taxonomy Team Lead with the AEM Zimmerman Team. Lydia and her fellow taxonomists are responsible for maintaining and updating the thesaurus and identifiers. This webinar will provide you an overview of how the ERIC thesaurus and identifiers are updated. Then, additions and changes from the recent thesaurus and identifiers update will be highlighted. We will talk about how you can contribute to the future updates of the ERIC thesaurus and identifiers. Finally, we will discuss how ERIC is striving to improve transparency about our processes and provide expanded access to the ERIC indexing vocabularies. Now I'm going to turn the presentation over to Lydia.
Thank you, Erin. To help you understand a bit more about how we update the thesaurus and identifiers, let's start with a quick overview of our process. The ERIC contract gives us 6 months to recommend and implement updates to the thesaurus and identifiers. During that time frame, terms to potentially add or change are identified. Some of those proposed new or changed terms are selected for further research. Based on that research, the taxonomists create proposed entries, including the term name, scope note, and relationships to other terms. After reviewing the proposals internally, they are then submitted to the Department of Education for review and approval. Once the recommended new and updated terms are approved, the thesaurus and identifiers are updated both in our indexing system and on the ERIC website. This process is highlighted in the infographic, How ERIC Develops Thesaurus Terms, available on the ERIC multimedia page in the thesaurus section. Now let's look at some of the changes we made to the thesaurus and the identifiers in the recent update, starting with some of our new descriptors. COVID-19 continues to have a huge impact on education, and that is being reflected in the ERIC thesaurus and identifiers. Prior to the pandemic, we started to see some content comparing online learning versus in-person learning. But that subject area exploded after COVID-19 came into our lives. This was a critical term to add, along with its synonym, face-to-face learning. The descriptor has only been in use for a few months, but it already has been used over 100 times. Technology use is a perennial hot topic in education. In recent years, the use of tablets, both in and outside of the classroom, has generated a lot of interest, and our existing terminology was no longer adequate. So we have added a new descriptor for tablet computers. Now, you might ask, why don't we just use tablets as a descriptor? Why do we need computers in the term? Generally speaking, when creating terms for the ERIC thesaurus, we want to use the most correct or official term possible, even if it isn't the most popular form of the term used. This helps to prevent confusion, especially in cases where a word or abbreviation might have several meanings. The word tablets can refer to several things, so by using the complete name as the descriptor, we are making it clear that the term refers only to computerized tablets and not other kinds of tablets, such as pills or pads of paper. Descriptors should be unambiguous so that searching ERIC gives you the best possible results. Whenever we are preparing to update the thesaurus, we are always looking at feedback from ERIC users. A user sent us a request to add trauma-informed to the thesaurus and kindly provided us with some excellent information to demonstrate how this would make a useful descriptor. We used that information, along with our own research, to create a new term, trauma-informed approach. One of the most fascinating parts of my job is seeing how language changes over time. It isn't quite here today, gone tomorrow, but the words we use to talk about subjects in the field of education do change and can change dramatically in a relatively short amount of time. A great example is the term autism spectrum disorders. The terminology used for autism, autism spectrum disorders, and Asperger's syndrome has changed multiple times over the years, which you can see reflected in our thesaurus, as well as other thesauri, such as the Thesaurus of Psychological Terms published by APA. For this update, we've brought our terminology in this area into alignment with current usage. Autism spectrum disorders, which was a synonym of pervasive developmental disorders, is now the single descriptor to be used to index content that would have previously been indexed under autism, pervasive developmental disorders, and Asperger syndrome. Not only does this modernize our indexing vocabulary, but it also should make searching easier since there will be a single descriptor rather than multiple descriptors to use in your search. No matter how hard we try, taxonomists can't predict the future. The language used in education not only changes over time, but it can also wax and wane. Terms may be retired, but then need to be reinstated as research on that subject resurges. In this update, we reinstated the former descriptor racism. This term was part of the very first edition of the thesaurus. Then, in 1980, the taxonomists at the time decided to retire racism as a term in favor of using either racial bias or racial discrimination. Although I don't know exactly why that decision was made, I can make an educated guess and say that the literature at the time was making that kind of distinction. However, in recent years, ERIC indexers have found that authors are not necessarily distinguishing between bias and discrimination. In addition, racism as a subject has not only had a resurgence in the public consciousness, but education research as well. If you've attended or listened to any of our previous webinars, you've probably heard me say that synonyms are my favorite terms in the thesaurus. Synonyms are like blazes on a trail or signs along the highway. They point the way to your destination. As part of every thesaurus update, we add synonyms to go along with the new descriptors we are adding, but we also add new synonyms for existing descriptors. We add these synonyms to help improve indexing quality and to provide ERIC users with new access points to existing terms. In this update, for example, we added young adult literature as a synonym for adolescent literature, machine learning as a synonym of artificial intelligence, vaping as a synonym for smoking, and paraeducators as a synonym of teacher aides. In addition to updating the thesaurus, we also updated the identifiers. Under the assessments and surveys list, we added several new test identifiers, including the Movement Assessment Battery for Children, the Utrecht Work Engagement Scale, Tennessee Comprehensive Assessment Program, and the Purdue Spatial Visualization Test. In the Laws, Policies, and Programs list, we added some more COVID-19 related terms, such as the Education Stabilization Fund, ESF, and the American Rescue Plan Act 2021. We also added Head Start, Early Head Start, and the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, or SNAP. Finally, we added some new foreign city identifiers to the location list, including Pakistan, Islamabad, Botswana, Gaborone, and Slovenia, Ljubljana. We also added a new regional term, Australasia. At ERIC, we are always looking for feedback from our users to help us improve the services we provide. Input from users of the ERIC thesaurus and identifiers is a key component in the update process and helps us make sure the ERIC indexing vocabularies meet our users' needs. If there are any terms you would like to see added or changed in the thesaurus or the identifiers, please email your suggestions to ericrequests@ed.gov. You don't need to provide a lot of information, but it would be very helpful for you to include the term you'd like to see added or changed and why you would like it to be added or changed. In addition, if you have any definitions or information about the term that you can provide, that will help the ERIC taxonomy team when they begin their review and research. All requests that we receive from ERIC users are reviewed and logged. While we may not be able to address them immediately, we keep all requests and review them each time we begin an update. Now I will turn things back over to Erin to talk about public access and transparency at ERIC.
Thanks, Lydia. At ERIC and the Department of Education as a whole, we are always looking for ways to better serve the public and provide more information to our stakeholders. Whether a user is an experienced researcher or just beginning their first search in ERIC, we want them to understand the benefits of using descriptors and identifiers in their search, as well as to provide them with information to help them construct a search that will give them the best possible results. To that end, we will soon be releasing an infographic that will demonstrate the differences between descriptors and keywords, as well as describe what ERIC indexers are looking for when they're determining which descriptors to add to an ERIC record. We hope that this will not only increase understanding of the indexing process, but will also make it clear how using descriptors in your search criteria can make searching easier, more precise, and lead you to the most relevant content ERIC has available. Another way we are improving access and transparency is by making the complete identifier list publicly available. And it's been a while since the complete lists were made available to the public, and we are excited to share them with you. This will allow you to locate a specific identifier to use in your search. Each list is presented alphabetically in a PDF so you can search for a specific identifier or browse. You can find these lists on the main thesaurus page below the thesaurus subject categories. Thank you so much for watching this webinar. For more information on the ERIC thesaurus and identifiers, please see the thesaurus section of the ERIC multimedia page or on the ERIC FAQs. Please send any questions or suggestions for improvement to the ERIC thesaurus and identifiers to ericrequests@ed.gov. Thank you again, everyone.